Have you ever had a friend come back from a concert so excited to tell you about the show? It was absolutely amazing, they said. They said it was 105 decibels. Wait, 105 decibels? That doesn't describe a concert. 105 decibels, that could describe a fire truck going by outside your window. 105 decibels is meaningless to describe an experience. Which experience was it? The concert or the fire truck? But yet we still put numbers on things as engineers. In fact, we put numbers on roughness. We say the surface finish must be less than 16 microinches RA in an old school kind of specification. Or maybe we'll say RA of 0.4 micrometers in a little more modern way of saying it. But this is the same thing. This is saying we have a number to describe roughness, but we're not really describing the shape of the roughness. For example, a surface could be scalloped and full of peaks, or a surface may be plateaued and mostly valleys, and these would have the same roughness, the same RA value. Now, this thing that we call RA, this average roughness, we can kind of think of it like decibels. It's kind of how much of something do we have? How much roughness do we have? Now, a long time ago, this was called AA, arithmetic average, or CLA, centerline average. Today, we just call it RA. Average roughness. A is for average, R is from the profile it came from, the roughness profile. And the actual calculation of RA isn't super descriptive and it isn't super hard to think about. If we measure a surface, we're measuring it with data points along the way. So our measured data points might look something like this. And the RA calculation is simply the average distance from the mean line for each of those data points. So we might have thousands of data points in a profile, or even millions in an areal data set, and the A calculation for RA or WA if we're looking at waviness, or PA for the primary, is simply the average distance from the mean line. We're going to average all of those distances, and the result is RA. So, since we're just averaging those distances, these two surfaces could average out to have the same RA value and yet act very differently. Can you imagine sitting on each one and sliding around? So, RA gets a bad rap for being not so descriptive. It can't describe these two surfaces. But perhaps RA could be useful, just like decibels could be useful, to represent changes within a process. For example, if the fire truck is a long ways away and getting louder, that means it's probably getting closer. So if the decibels of the fire truck are increasing, that tells us something about a change in the fire truck. Maybe within the turning process, RA is increasing or decreasing, and we know that relates to the tool of the turning process. So maybe RA getting a bad rap for not being able to distinguish two processes is certainly real, but maybe as a change detector within a process, it still can be useful. So nonetheless, not a lot of people do come home from a concert and say it was great because it was 105 decibels. We should think about roughnesses the same way.